Brent Bozell, one of my great friends and heroes, founder of the Media Research Center and that entire enterprise, and president of the Media Research Center. How are you, sir?
Good, Mark. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Now, tell me, you're up to something with this MSLSD. What are you doing with this MSLSD?
Well, you know the line. I've taken all I can. I can't take no more.
Yeah.
I've had it with them. I've had it with the dishonesty. I've had it with the shameless posturing. I've had it with the hypocrisy. And it's time to call them out on it. This is a network that is obsessed with the idea of knocking Rush Limbaugh off the air because of one comment he made. This is a network that makes that kind of comment and things a hundredfold more offensive on a daily basis, and has gotten away with it. And they've gotten away with it because conservatives have decided we had other more important things to do, which we normally do, and we have thought that we shouldn't pay attention to MSNBC because they're irrelevant. But it's time they got called out, and it's time that they called on the carpet. So I've called on Phil Griffin, the man who heads MSNBC, and the man who hired Ed Schultz and who gave him a promotion, to take responsibility for the man and take ownership of his comments and to fire the guy. Because what Ed Schultz has been saying on that television program is far, far worse than anything Rush Limbaugh has ever said in 25 years speaking to the radio.
Mr. Producer, we have a montage provided by Brent Bozell. Did we have to bleep anything? Have you gone through it, or we're good? Brent Bozell, do you mind if I play it?
Please do.
All right, this is Ed Schultz on MSNBC, a.k.a. MSLSD, who is one of the proud hires of Phil Griffin, the president of MSNBC. And isn't it interesting, Brent, that nobody knows who Phil Griffin is, and everyone knows who Roger Ailes is?
Well, that's right. The left has made it a point to personalize the Fox News network by talking about individuals. Fine. We're going to give them a taste of their own medicine. We're going to start talking about the individuals responsible for that network.
Here's Ed Schultz for your listening displeasure. Go.
Hold it right there. The Republicans lie. They want to see you dead. This is what the Republican Party stands for, though. Racism.
Sometimes I think they want Obama to get shot. I do. I really think that there are conservative broadcasters in this country who would love to see Obama taken out.
You know, I just sense that we are going down a very dangerous road right now when a political organization like the Tea Party has members trying to intimidate elected public officials. Folks, this is what the brown shirts did in the 1930s in Germany. I will fight these bastards every night at 6 o'clock because I know what they're up against. They want to destroy the American dream.
Does the word whore apply? Shove those bastards right into the dirt hole. This is about power. It's about winning. You damn right Dick Cheney's heart's a political football. We ought to rip it out and kick it around and stuff it back in him.
Like this right-wing slut, what's her name, Laura Ingraham? Yeah, she's a talk slut.
You know, I never heard half of this before because, of course, I don't watch that waste of a carbon footprint. And as a matter of fact, this guy's up against me, which is why he doesn't get ratings. But all that said, has there been any rising up challenging any of this?
You know, think about something here, Mark. With all the outrage against Rush Limbaugh for using the word slut, and you've heard so many people at MSNBC, one after another, trying to keep that story alive day after day after day after day. Everybody, Al Sharpton, Chris Matthews, they're all with the drumbeat trying to keep it alive. Can you recall, and if your audience can put their thinking caps on this, can you recall anybody at MSNBC, anybody at the New York Times, anybody at CNN, at ABC, at CBS, at Headline News, at the Washington Post, anyone who has gone after Rush Limbaugh? Can you name me a person who went after Ed Schultz for calling Laura Ingraham a slut?
Nope.
And that's just one. Now, you listen to that whole montage. Have you ever heard Rush Limbaugh say anything close to any one of those quotes? Again, the answer is no. Have you ever heard any one of those reporters who were upset with Rush Limbaugh ever express any outrage at anything that Ed Schultz has said along the lines that we just played you? Again, the answer is no. This is the hypocrisy of the left. They don't care what Rush said. They just want to get Rush.
By the way, do you know off the top of your head, did Tom Brokaw speak out against Ed Schultz?
No, I haven't seen it. No.
How about Brian Williams? Has he spoken out against Ed Schultz?
No, no. No, there's no outrage. I've got to think that people like Tom Brokaw, who, as liberal as he was not a radical along the lines of what's at MSNBC now. I've got to wonder, what must they be thinking about what happened to their network that was taken over by these people? They've got to be appalled, professionally appalled by what's happened. This isn't news.
And you're demanding that Phil Griffin, the president of MSNBC, step down.
He should take responsibility. Isn't that the thing that you do? Isn't that what they're calling on Rush Limbaugh to do, to take responsibility? This man should take ownership. He hired Ed Schultz. He put him there. He gave him a raise. He's kept him there. He's promoted him. He speaks laudatorily of him wherever he has an opportunity to do so. If he's going to do that, take responsibility for him. And yeah, I think he should go.
Now, who owns MSNBC?
Comcast did the merger. Comcast took over the cable company. Yeah, took over it. And today we sent a letter to Brian Roberts, the chairman of the board of Comcast, again calling on Comcast to take ownership. This is, you bought it, it's yours. This is your network. You're responsible for what's on it. People have got to start taking some responsibility here. Especially because Mark, I'm going to make the left eat its words. All those attacks on Rush, I'm going to expose them for the utter hypocrites they are. Up one side and back down the other. All those people who either attack Rush or let their people attack Rush, they're now going to take ownership for the fact that their side is 100-fold more offensive than anything Rush ever said. And they've never said a word about it.
Now, by the way, if people want to keep track of what you're doing or support you, where do they go?
Come to our website, mrc.org, and join the course and join the petition and sign in there and contact Comcast and contact MSNBC and let your voice. Conservatives have to speak up, Mark, and they've got to say, we've had it. We're mad as hell, and we're not going to take it anymore. I think the left has badly overreached on this one. But I'm going to be proven correct only if conservatives speak out. But we have to, because this is bigger. This is bigger than Rush Limbaugh. He may be number one. They're after the whole industry. They're after you. They're after Sean Hannity. They're after Lauren Ingram. They're after the talk radio industry. Because what they're telling the advertisers is, stay away from all these guys because they're nothing but trouble. Well, guess what? The reason that you all dominate that industry is because you're the opposite of trouble. You're the welcome relief that the American public wants, which is why all of you guys are so popular. But now your listeners have got to stand up, and they've got to start contacting the advertisers, and they've got to start contacting the other side and letting them know, we're not going to stand for this anymore.
And let me underscore
something. Mark, you and I didn't have a conversation before the show, and you didn't ask me to say anything.
No, that's exactly right. So now, so they go to mrc.org, correct?
Yeah, yes, absolutely. We're gonna have some more things to say next week. The first couple of days we're gonna be talking about Mr. Schultz. Next week we're gonna have some conversations about Mr. Sharpton and the things that he's responsible for, and the kind of language and vitriol that he's responsible for that would get you fired in a New York second if you said what he said, and he's on the record saying it, and he's gotten away with it. We're going to be talking about that. We're going to be calling on MSNBC to take responsibility. They put them. They gave them a job. And Comcast bought MSNBC. They're responsible for him as well. We're going to be talking about Chris Matthews. We're going to be talking about all of them. These people are going to rue the day that they went after Rush Limbaugh this way.
Let me ask you this. Have you gotten a response to your letters?
Oh, no, no, no. They're not going to respond because they think they don't have to respond. I think they're very happy being in last place. They're very happy losing their shirts. And I think they're thinking, yeah, it can't get any worse. Well, I intend to make it worse.
All right. That's MRC.com. MRC.com.
.org.
Oh, I apologize. MRC.org. Mr. Producer, let's get that up on the sites. You're going to be on Fox tonight, is that correct?
Yeah, Mr. Hannity and I are going to have a conversation as well.
All right, Brent. God bless you, my friend.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
All right, you take care. That's Brent Bozell of the Media Research Center. Amazing. Okay, I have a feeling that Media Matters has awakened a sleeping giant, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, yes, I do. I have a feeling they've awakened a sleeping giant, and that would be you. MRC.org. Is that what it was, Mr. Producer? Boy, am I slow on the uptake right now.